Just, O Lord, and your judgment is right. Treat your servant in accord with your merciful love. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart, Lord of mercy.
Lord of mercy.
Came to call sinners, Christ of mercy.
Christ of mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord of mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting
Amen.
Life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, by whom we are redeemed and receive adoption, look graciously upon your beloved sons and daughters, that those who believe in Christ may receive true freedom and an everlasting inheritance. So our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen.
First reading, a reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. I have been told as an undoubted fact that one of you is living with his father's wife. This is a case of sexual immorality among you that must be unparalleled even among pagans. How can you be so proud of yourselves? You should be in mourning. A man who does a thing like that ought to have been expelled from the community. Though I am far away in body, I am with you in spirit, and have already condemned the man who did this thing as if I were actually present. When you are assembled together in the name of the Lord Jesus, and I am spiritually present with you, then with the power of our Lord Jesus, he is to be handed over to Satan, so that his sensual body may be destroyed and his spirit saved on the day of the Lord. The pride that you take in yourselves is hardly to your credit. You must know how even a small amount of yeast is enough to leaven all the dough. So get rid of all the old yeast and make yourselves into a completely new batch of bread, unleavened as you are meant to be. Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. Let us celebrate the feast then by getting rid of all the old yeast of evil and wickedness, having only the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response to the psalm is, lead me, Lord, in your justice.
Lead me, Lord, in your justice.
You are no God who loves evil. No sinner is your guest. The boastful shall stand their ground before your face.
Lead me, Lord, in your justice.
You hate all who do evil. You destroy all who lie. The deceitful and bloodthirsty man the Lord detests.
Lead me, Lord, in your justice.
All those who protect shall be glad and ring out their joy. You shelter them, in you they rejoice, those who love your name.
Lead me, Lord, in your justice.
Gospel acclamation.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Your word is a lamp for my steps and a light for my path.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with
you. And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
On the Sabbath, Jesus went into the synagogue and began to teach. And a man was there whose right hand was withered. The scribes and the Pharisees were watching him to see if he would cure a man on the Sabbath, hoping to find something to use against him. But he knew their thoughts, and he said to the man with the withered hand, "Stand up, come out into the middle." And he came out and stood there. Then Jesus said to them, "I put it to you, is it against the law on the Sabbath to do good or to do evil, to save life or to destroy it?" Then he looked round at them all and said to the man, "Stretch out your hand." He did so, and his hand was better. But they were furious and began to discuss the best way of dealing with Jesus. Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Come, O Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful, and enkindle in them the fire of your love. Send forth your Spirit, and they shall be created.
And you shall renew the face of the earth.
Renew the face of the earth. Let us pray. O God, who by the light of the Holy Spirit didst instruct the hearts of the faithful, grant that by the light of the same Spirit we may be truly wise and ever rejoice in his consolation. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
O Mary, conceived without sin.
Pray for us, who have recourse to you.
O Mary, conceived without sin.
Pray for us, who have recourse to you.
O Mary, conceived without sin.
Pray for us, who have recourse to you.
Most Holy Virgin, I believe and confess your Holy and Immaculate Conception.
Pure and without sin. O most pure Virgin, to your Virgin of purity, your Immaculate Conception, your glorious prerogative, Mother of God, obtain for us your divine Son, humility, charity, great purity of mind and body,
a
a gift of prayer,
and a holy life, and a happy death. Amen. Memorare. Remember, O most compassionate Virgin Mary, that never was it known that anyone who fed to your protection, implored your assistance, or sought your intercession, was left unaided. Inspired with this confidence, apply unto you, O Virgin of Virgins, our Mother. To you we come, before you we need, sinful and sorrowful. O Mother, the Word Incarnate, despise not our petitions, but in your clemency hear and answer them. Amen. Act of confidence. O Immaculate Virgin, Mother of Mercy, Refuge of Sinners, who by a wondrous revelation to St. Catherine did promise that all who confidently wear the miraculous medal and come to the altar repeating the prayer, Mary conceived without sin, pray for us who have recourse to you, would receive abundant graces. We poor sinners, encouraged by your promise, come with the utmost confidence to implore your powerful intercession. Amen. Novena prayer. O Immaculate Virgin Mary, Mother of our Lord Jesus Christ, and our Mother, penetrated with the most lively confidence in your all-powerful and ever-failing intercession, manifested so often through the miraculous medal, we, your loving and trustful children, implore you to obtain for us the graces and favours we ask during this novena, if to be beneficial to our immortal souls and the souls for whom. And we remember the month's mind of baby Cahir Hamon and baby Lucas, and also the anniversaries of Mary Malloy, Margaret Foy, and Joan Goodwin. May their souls and the souls of all the faithful departed, to the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. Let us pray. You know, O Mary, how often our souls have been the sanctuaries of your Son, who hates iniquity. Obtain for us a deep hatred of sin, and that purity of heart which will attach us to God alone, so that our every thought, word, and deed may tend to his greater glory. Obtain for us also a spirit of prayer and self-denial, that we may recover by penance what we have lost by sin, and at length attain to that blessed abode where you are the Queen of Angels and of men. Amen. Act of consecration to Our Lady of the Miraculous Medal. O Virgin Mother of God, Mary Immaculate, we dedicate and consecrate ourselves to you under the title of Our Lady of the Miraculous Medal. May this medal be for each one of us a sure sign of your affection for us, and a constant reminder of our duties towards you. Ever while wearing it, may we be blessed by your loving protection and preserved in the grace of your Son. O Virgin most powerful, Mother of our Saviour, keep us close to you every moment of our lives. Obtain for us, your children, the grace of a happy death, so that in union with you we may enjoy the bliss of heaven forever. O Mary, conceived without sin.
Pray for us who have recourse to thee.
O Mary, conceived without
sin. Pray for us who have recourse to thee.
O Mary, conceived without
sin. Pray for us who have recourse to thee.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. For through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. O God, who give us the gift of true prayer and peace, graciously grant that through this offering we may do fitting homage to your divine majesty, and by partaking of the sacred mystery, we may be faithfully united in mind and heart through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let's give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Saviour and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin. Fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory as with one voice we acclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Eamon our Bishop, his assistant Bishop Michael, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Joseph, her venerable spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. Only say the word and my soul shall be healed. the act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you're already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you.
Amen.
Amen. Let us pray. Grant that your faithful, O Lord, whom you nourish and endow with life, through the food of your word and heavenly sacrament, may so benefit from your beloved Son's great gifts that we may merit an eternal share in his life, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. Go in peace and stay safe.